Tangs, when you hear John Tavares, one of the best players in the league as well, heap praise upon a guy like Auston Matthews, what does that tell you about the importance of Matthews to Tavares and this team?
He prays and he's thankful because, you know, you look at the luxury or the chance to play with a guy like Auston Matthews. For John Tavares, who's a number one center in the National Hockey League, one of the best premier playmaker. But when you have Auston Matthews, what's happening? The best defenseman on the other team, they'll play against Auston Matthews because we all see the shooting ability. You know, 12, you know, we talk about the goals that he's been scoring, the way that he scored, the release point. You know, there's so many options, and Auston Matthews, he's a big guy. He's 6'3", he's hard to defend, he's really hard. So I think it slots everybody on their team just a little bit better. And I think John Tavares, Mitch Marner, they get that luxury of having that second deep pair. You're talking Mitch Marner and John Tavares, two of the best premium goal scorer in the National Hockey League that gets the chance to play lower in the lineup because of the quality of Auston Matthews. Auston Matthews has been a superstar in the making. We've all seen, you know, the play that he's been able to make, the way that he gathers the puck, the attention that he gets, and he doesn't shy away from it. He wants to be that difference maker on a nightly basis. I would not be surprised. I know that he's just coming back, and we don't have a captain yet in Toronto, but that day is coming real soon where this guy will be the captain of that team.
Yeah, because not only does he give them more depth, as you were talking about, 5-on-5, but also on the power play. You mentioned it briefly in the highlight, but let's take a little deeper look at that power play with Matthews back. What was the difference?
Well, the options are just endless with that power play. You look at, you know, the way that they can move the puck. Mitch Marner is a premium playmaker, and the way that he passes the puck, you know, he creates movement with his body. He creates movement with his hands. Morgan Riley at the top moves the puck laterally side to side. And when they don't, they have the guy in front of the net that can be that option. We see Janssen there making the pass. We saw Tavares moving to the outside on the first play that Matthews gave him the puck. There is so many weapons on this power play that, you know, like, you don't know where to go. You don't know where to defend. And oftentimes on power play, chances are created by moving your feet, moving the puck, and making sure that you're on par with what everybody else is doing. And the Leafs power play, with everybody back, and they're one guy that's still missing that we're going to talk about a little bit later, but when everybody's back, that power play is going to be spectacular.
Yeah, they look scary as ever, and again, we mentioned 6th straight win at home, so they're rolling on home ice. Meanwhile, the Sharks are in the midst of a 5-game road trip, and things have not gone well for them on the road. Look at that, 4-6-3 away from the Shark Tank. This is a team a lot of people picked to go to the Stanley Cup final, but what did they need to do to try to figure it out on the road?
Well, I think one of the easiest way, you look at the goals per games and the goals against. I think that, you know, limiting your amount of goals against per game is certainly something that they're going to need to address. You know, goaltender Martin Jones is one of the premier goaltender in the NHL. I really like his ability to play net. He's big, he's strong. Arundel was in net tonight. Maybe goaltending needs to be a little bit better, but I do believe that there was some distraction for them on this road trip. You look at Evander Kane making his return in Buffalo last night. You look at next game, we're going to Ottawa while all eyes are going to be on Eric Karlsson. So there's been some distraction with this team, but this team is coached as well as any team in the NHL. I like that coaching staff. Peter DeBoer always finds a way to get the best out of his troops, so I have no doubt that they'll be able to get some success on the road. This team is too good, too deep not to win on the road.